Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be explaining you pulsed radar system in great details. Here I'll be explaining you working waveforms and block diagram of pulsed radar system. First of all, let me explain you how pulsed radar system functions. See, pulsed radar system transmits high frequency EM wave for short duration of pulse. After that, it will be having waiting duration. During that waiting duration, it will be receiving reflected echo signal from the target. And by comparing transmitted wave and reflected received wave, it will be identifying range of the target. Let me show it to you by animation over here. If you observe, here we have pulsed radar system. By blue color, for short duration, it is transmitting high frequency EM wave towards the target. That transmitted wave is having power in terms of few kilowatts to megawatt. Here, from the target, we have reflected echo signal, red color signal that is going towards radar. So that is reflected echo signal that is having strength in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 watt to 10 to the power minus 15 watt. So here, pulsed radar system is transmitting high frequency EM wave for short duration of pulse. After that, it is waiting for reflected echo signal from the target. And based on comparison of transmitted wave and received wave, here it will be identifying range of this target. Let me show it to you in terms of time domain. So here I'll be now explaining you waveforms in terms of time domain. So here on y-axis we have power, on x-axis we have time. First of all, let me show you transmitted wave. So here you can observe transmitted wave is there, where during this pulse, we will be transmitting high frequency EM wave. We are not transmitting pulse. Remember, during this pulse, we are transmitting high frequency EM wave, right? After that, here we have waiting time duration. And during this waiting time duration, we are receiving reflected echo signal from the target. By red color, you can observe here we have reflected wave. So this echo signal and transmitted wave both are compared over here, and based on time difference in between transmitted and reflected echo signal, one can identify range of the radar, right? Velocity of this EM wave, that is velocity of light. So velocity is equals to distance by time. Here we are calculating time by comparing these two signal, and distance is R plus R. Based on that, we can easily identify range of the target. If you observe strength of this transmitted wave, that is by 1 megawatt of peak power. And if you observe strength of this reflected wave, that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 watt. Here, there are a few parameters that you need to understand. Like if you observe, here we have two consecutive pulses. In between that, time duration is T. So this time duration T, that explains you pulse repetition frequency. So pulse repetition frequency, that is 1 by T. Value of pulse repetition frequency, that is very essential. We need to keep it low so that we can receive this reflected wave before we send second consecutive pulse, right? If you increase the value of pulse repetition frequency, then it is possible that we may be transmitting second pulse and echo is received after second pulse. At that time, you cannot identify correct range. For example, if you double the pulse repetition frequency, then here there will be second pulse that is been transmitted by radar over here and echo that will be received over here. So in that situation, this echo that is there for this pulse, which will be resulting into false range calculation over here. So we need to keep pulse repetition frequency by some lower value so that we can receive echo signal before transmission of second pulse, right? There is one more essential parameter that you need to understand. See, here we have T on duration. Based on T on duration, we are transmitting EM wave in the space over here and duty cycle over here, that is T on divided by T. Usually with pulsed radar system, that duty cycle will be 0.1% to 0.2%. So for short duration only, we are transmitting high frequency, high power pulse in which we will be having continuous EM wave, right? That is there in terms of gigahertz. And after that, there is a waiting duration. And during this waiting duration, we will be receiving reflected echo signal at this antenna, right? Now let me explain you how block diagram is there. You can see block diagram of pulsed radar system over here, in which we have three major elements: transmitter, receiver and antenna. Here this transmitter is transmitting high power pulse over here, and receiver is receiving very weak pulse over here, right? Here transmitter and receiver is separated by duplexer over here, as we use only one antenna. First of all, let me explain you transmitter section. With the use of power amplifier, here we are transmitting high power signal. That power is there in terms of megawatt over here. Inside transmitter, we have two other elements, pulse modulator and wave generator. This pulse modulator, that is generating pulse over here. That pulse is having width in terms of microsecond, and frequency, that is pulse repetition frequency, which will be there in terms of few megahertz, right? So here see pulse modulator, that is generating pulse with pulse repetitive frequency around 1 megahertz, and its duty cycle is around 0.001. Here wave generator is generating high frequency carrier wave. This carrier wave that we are transmitting over here during this pulse only with the use of power amplifier, right? So after power amplifier, here we will be having high power, high frequency pulse over here, right? And that is what we are transmitting over here with this antenna. Now I'll explain you duplexer part. See this duplexer, that we use it to separate high power transmitter and low power receiver. Here in pulse radar system, we are having single antenna. So, but obviously duplexer will be transmitting signal with the use of transmitter, and after transmission, whatever echo signal that is coming over here, that is forwarded to receiver over here with the use of duplexer. But remember, here transmitter is functioning at very high power and receiver is functioning at very weak signal. So it is very essential that we need to isolate transmitter from the receiver, and that job is done with the use of duplexer over here. So duplexer is isolating high power transmitter and low power receiver. See, transmitted signal is directly transferred to the antenna. So here transmitter is giving signal to antenna with the use of duplexer, and received echo signal, that is transferred to receiver. So received echo signal, that is transferred over here to receiver over here. And here received signal, that is very weak, that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 15 volt. Now I'll explain you receiver section. See, in receiver section, first block, that is low noise amplifier. As I have told you, we are receiving very weak signal. So first of all, we need to amplify that very weak signal without adding any noise. So low noise amplifier, that is having characteristic which will be amplifying signal only. It will not add much noise with the signal, as signal is very weak over here. After low noise amplifier, here we have mixer and oscillator. See, with low noise amplifier, we will be having RF signal, right? With low noise amplifier, we will be having RF signal over here, right? And after that, we have mixer and oscillator. So mixer and oscillator, that is used to convert RF signal into IF signal. So RF signal, that is very high frequency, that is there in terms of gigahertz. Now with the use of mixer and oscillator, intermediate frequency, that is getting generated over here, right? So now we have IF pulse. So this frequency of IF, that is lower than RF. After that, we have second detector or modulator, that is used to have elimination of carrier. So now here we don't have any carrier, we just have pulse over here, right? And after that, we have video amplifier. See this pulse, that is there in terms of megahertz of frequency, right? So this pulse now, that is getting compared with this transmitted pulse over here with the use of threshold decision, and based on that we can identify location of target by calculating time duration in between transmitted pulse and received pulse, right? That is how complete block diagram is functioning with pulsed radar system, I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.